Right, welcome back to part two. Let's get it cracking on. My name's Sergeant Fury Toes. I've opened up my bum cheeks. We're doing a fucking crispy fucking pork fucking chowy wowy thing. I know what I'm doing. I've got wooden spoon. I've got my tile boards. Washing machine's just said bollocks again. And we're going to get on with it. Right, so now I did do some other little interesting aspects to the dish as I put it in the fridge. And then thought to myself, no, I've done it slightly wrong. So what I basically did and had to redo, is basically the situation is this. So we saw all the spices and all that business that we put in the pork and then we put it in the fridge. Yeah? Tick that box because that's a fucking A-OK, right? That's exactly what we did. But what we didn't do, and I forgot to do, because I thought about, as 10 minutes scan into the video, I thought, shit, no, actually, we need to actually try and get this pork softened as much as we can. So I took it out of the fridge, I squeezed in about just under half an orange juice into the actual beef itself. I put some more corn flour. I actually put about a big dollop of corn flour, mixed it all in, and also some bicarb of soda. Yeah, and I forgot to mention that, so that's what we put in. Now what that's going to do, that's going to help to soften that and break down that pork. So that was like 40-50 minutes ago now, so that's the situation, so that should be actually fine. So we're going to start to deep fry some stuff, okay? So the pork can just sit there for the moment, we ain't got to worry about that. But what I want to do is I want to deep fry the almost like, let's call them like trinkets that are going to go on into and onto the actual pork itself. So we've got some ginger, so we're just going to peel that. So we're going to deep fry all these items. So we're going to deep fry the ginger, we're going to deep fry the garlic, and we're going to deep fry the green and red chilies. Now while we're doing that, now is this going to be enough ginger? I don't know, because we are going to need ginger a little bit. There we go. Let's whack that there. So I want to just, I'm going to go with the grain of the ginger, which basically like runs lengthways. Alright, so we want to try and get as much out of it as we can. That was a slight error of judgment now, very rarely seen on the channel by the sergeant, because obviously we are basically awaiting Michelin promotion stardomness, and that is just how it goes, I'm afraid to say. You know, some of us have got that Michi, and some of us cooks or makes some Rice Krispies with some peanut butter in it. That's all I'm gonna fucking say, mate. That's all I need to say. Right, doing that again, bigger slices. We're decorating, this is just decoration really that we're just creating, right, or trying to. Right, okay, so the ginger's going to help, right, it's going to help to get into all the aspects of that, that crispy pork, right, even though it'll be an aspect of eye decoration, it will give, you know, every aspect of this dish extra flavour. Right, same as the garlic. We want to keep them all fairly the same size if we can. And then we want to spread them out. So we want to get as much out of one garlic in spreadage as we can. Now, this is a different part of cooking. Yeah, this is a part of cooking that is, we're doing this basically ahead of schedule, so we want to have this all done and ready, so when the final pork is done, we will be on point with it. All right, so there we go. The same again. Yeah, so anyway, so yeah, so a little story about Double Agent 118 there, Captain Bob. Yeah, so you know, he's got a lot of ingenuity on his side. Apparently he has gained altitude now and he's drifting back. He's luckily been able to miss. I think the reason why now I can understand why he dropped to such a low altitude is because he wanted to miss that jet stream that takes him from basically the west coast of Africa over to the other side of the world, really. And he's been able to sort of like drop under that. So now he's like, he's coming into the view of the coast of like Portugal. So, you know, it's all pretty coastal sailing. And that was an email that was sent earlier today. So I'm not too concerned. We've now got our garlics, all right. So that's part of this done on this dish, on this part. Now what we're going to do is we're going to introduce the chilies. Now these are another important aspect. So what we're going to try and broadside these chilies. Yeah, this is called broadsiding. So what we're doing is we're taking the length of that chili and cutting it into strip ways like this. Yeah. And it's all going to get deep fried. Now I need to check my, now I have no temperature gauge on my deep fryer. If you want to be able to check it, dip a wooden thing in. If it starts frying, it's good for cooking. Right, okay, let's do it. So yeah, no temperature gauge, you know, no weighing machines or anything like that. We do everything by eye. We do it by eye and knowledge. Knowledge and skillage is what gets us through the day, mate. That's why everyone's able to, like, you know, we've even got our proper like gang rank members and rank members, yeah. So, you know, Johnny K is basically sometimes I leave him awestruck. Sometimes I reduce Lieutenant Sheep unit to hiding behind a sofa. Poloski's a little bit more hardcore. I think anything I try to do to bamboozle Mr. Lieutenant Poloski would be fairly difficult. He does appreciate good shit when it's done, but he has the right, and same as Sergeant Major Rylesworth, which is his actual duty, to be critical and to tell me and the rest of the gang membership where we're going wrong. Now on the gang membership, now I am extremely pleased to announce, yeah, that we have got to 265 gang members, yeah. 265 people. I mean, this is getting up there now. I'm getting spangoozled on my spangoogleys, right? It's mental. Right, now talking about mental, so I'd like to thank all the new people. Welcome aboard. There will be some more madness that comes up, yeah. We don't fuck around on the channel, yeah. We want to have a fucking fag and a beer, we do it, you know. If I fucking off, leant over and done something and you just hear out a squeaky fucking guffy fart come out of my fucking bum crack, that's what happens. Right, I'm going to check camera productions before we do any mergers on this. Right. Now here we go, we're going to get ready and we're going to get prepared. I want all items of preparation to be involved in. I've got a bit of fag ash in that bowl there. Right, okay, still in there, oh fuck off. Right, I'm going to scoop out these ingredients with this tea strainer and I'm going to put them in this bowl, yeah. That's what we're going to do. That's the plan. Or I might use double spoon and do it. We don't know, we're going to have it ready. So always be prepared and be ready. Right, or we could just chuck it all in here and just sink it in, I don't know. Right, I'm going to do it individually, actually. I'm going to do it individually, let's do that. That might be an easier way to do it. Or is it best to just, I don't know. Now, we'll just chuck it in. Right, we're chucking in ginger first. Right, that's fried off quite drastically. I want to do each individual item separately. I don't want to do it all together. I prefer a bit of separation. I prefer a bit of separation between the spices now, because we are having to watch very carefully at what's going on. I need to do this the other way around. I need to do it left-handed, and I can't do it left-handed. Fuck that. Right. Okay. So all we're looking for these is colour. All right, and we have to call that colour when we see it. This is where it takes a very specialised eye of basically reaching Michi double Michi standards of Michi's. Right, here we go, I'm taking them out now. Right, I'm gonna take them out. They're fine, they're all good in the hood. Right, they're doing, now that's the ginger. So we've got, we're rescuing ginger at the moment. We're on ginger rescuing. I'm actually rescuing gingers. I never rescue a ginger. Yeah, we don't do ginger rescuing. Right, I'm gonna put them in now. Right, so that's the crispy ginger. Yeah, that's gonna be all good in the hood as well, right? Right, next we're gonna go for the garlic. Now, the garlic is gonna be a different measure. We're talking about a garlic situation that has never been witnessed and seen before on this channel. Right, my name's Sergeant Fury Toes. I need wooden spoon. We've got some hardcore fucking slice up garlic here done by basically Michelin standards. I'm gonna put it in the fucking fire. Hold on to your bum cheeks. Don't hide behind the sofa and fucking let that fart rip. There we go. Right, now we're doing some serious business now. Now, I've got a wooden spoon out. That will give me the power of inspirational ability of wooden spoon. Right. Right, I'm watching that garlic transform before it. We're watching it transform before our eyes, mate. You know, that's all we can say. Just getting in tune with our fellow Chinese, yeah, you know, who are extremely, you know, quite a powerful nation actually. You know, you think about the Chinese situation that's going on, you know, they're doing some serious shit, and the world loves them for it, right? Especially their food, you know, nobody can deny it. Everyone loves a good Chinese. I'm going to whack them back in again briefly. They weren't slightly, I want them slightly more cooked than that. If you're not happy with that situation, don't ever deny it, right? Don't ever witness and say, oh no, I've got to stall it out and say, no, I need it done now. If it takes a few more seconds, it takes a few more seconds. You want to get it to that certain colour, and that's what we're aiming for at the moment, right? We're aiming for colour. We're aiming for textural colour, tranquil colour, garlic colour. And there we go. There we go. That's what we're going for, that sort of coverage. Well, I know a lot of people can see that, but don't worry, it won't be a problem. Right, we will sort it out in the dish. Right, now for the final bit, the chilies. We're whacking in chilies now. There they go. Now they're going to be more reactive and they're going to take less time to do because they are basically mostly water. Right, so we've got to be very proactive with them chilies because I want them to have the colour, but I don't want them to be singed to death, right? We're not looking for dead chilies, but we're looking for live ones. Right, okay. Coming out. We've got to be very quick with the rescue here now. We are scooping chilies. We're on chili scoop. Yep. Basically, and I'm predicting, like, if you used to do loads of this, also that is relevant on talking about chili scooping is probably the buffalo chicken wings I done the other day. If anyone actually made them to my specifications of amazement, you'd be fucking chili scooping as well, but out of your arse cheeks. So right, okay, now that's going to be the flavoured mixture that we're going to whack on, all right? Can't really see it too well, but if I get a little spoon and do something like that, so I'm just going extra for you, right? So that's what I mean. So we want it all to be like crisp and things like that. So that's going to go on. What is that there? Oh, don't say that's what it is. God's sake. If anyone saw that, I don't know what it, I can't see it because I didn't see it, but I'll see it when I re-watch the video. And if it is what I think it is, then that's really annoying. It's like annoyance from a certain gob that has lots of bloody hair and I don't like it, so fuck off. Right, okay, so this is what we're going to do now. So we've got our extra flavourful chilli garlicky, gingery situation that's gone on there. That's going to end up going in a bowl along with salt, black pepper, and white pepper and all that business. Right, now it's time. It is time, and we do have to do this now. We are going to do. I'm going to get a bowl that is massively too big for my kitchen, and we're going to need to start to do the actual business now. Right. So here we're going to go. We're going to pour in this. I could have just done it in there, but I didn't do that, and the reason why is because I want it in a bowl for a reason. I'm trying to actually think of the main reason. I'm still struggling, but I will gloss over that, right? Because one such as an expert as myself has no need to be looking upon about details like a bowl, right, here we go. Right, corn flour, 1, 2, I'm going for 3, right, I'm going to go 3, right, but it's not only corn flour we want in this, no, we're not looking just for corn flour, we want this to be a dish that's going to be never forgotten in history of man, yeah, so we're looking for garlic powder. Right, I want Chinese five spice. That goes in as well. Yeah. Got the chili flakes. It's a silent part of the video, this is about assembling. It's about taking stock and seeing what you've got and what you can rock with and what you can't. Yeah. And we're rocking with some business. Yeah. We're rocking with some business. A bit of salt. Now, there's a couple of other things I want to put in here and I don't know what to do. I don't know if I've got a mind that tells me to do A or a mind that tells me to do B. I've got a feeling, yeah, I'm just saying it out there. I'm going to put in a little bit of pure sesame seed oil into this, just a little dribble, a real little dribble, right, and a little tiny touch of honey as well, just a little bit. Right, now they're going to give this pork some crucial flavours. If I need to put in more corn flour, I will have that ready. Always have your corn at the ready, yeah. And here we go, we're going to go mixing. We're mixing it up now. All them things are going to be taken into account into this dish now. Right, it looks like the corn flour is going to do its job. Right, okay. There we go. Now, we've got some almost like breadcrumb looking stuff now here. This is what you call pre-done corn flour stage one triple business, yeah. This is where lots of different aspects of things come in that nobody has ever been aware of, and even I get shocked by them because it's just too triple. Right, we've got a little bit of smokage coming from the oil. I believe that's going to be too hot now, so I'm going to lower that down. I do not want smokage and I don't want it too hot. Alright, okay. Right, we're going to filter this out, and I'll be able to do that. I want an ability. I'm going to have to do it over the bin, so let's hope we don't do any pork dropping or anything like that, because that would not be good. Oh shit, right, okay. Leave it there. Right, I'm going to take each individual piece out. I don't know why I just did that, that was really dumb. Right, okay, we don't do dumbness on the channel, obviously, because I'm too amazing. Right, let's just sprinkle it out. I've used up a thing I didn't need to use, but under excessive circumstances, you know, mistakes do happen. Right, okay, we're in there under control. Right, I've got the control. And there we are. Right, now, this is where it's going to get serious now. because I think that oil is slightly too hot. I really do. I'm not happy. I'm not happy. I've got a feeling it's far too hot. We're going to stick our stick of inspiration in. We might be lucky. Right, okay, we've got to catch this as this comes out, okay? And I need to have it a plate ready. I need a plate ready. It's going to be sufficient to be able to catch all this. So. Right, okay, here we go. Right. I'm just going to do four at a time. I'm not going to risk any multitude of fuck ups now. This is a really hardcore moment. Right, we're not pissing around. We're having to really watch really carefully, actually. Oh, shit. There we go. And that's what I mean. Oh, wow. Right. That's quick. So it's quick. Now, it was slightly too quick, right? So they're fine. We're going to go with that. That's not a bad. That's a nice little colour on them. That's fine. Right, 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're sticking with the 4. That oil has really got some serious punching power into it now. I'm going to keep an eye on them. They're really going to cook up fast. So these are going to be extremely juicy. Yeah, I'm calling that a day. That is a day one expiration export. Right, so we've got some nice colour on these babies now. Now, this is what I was gaming for the chow mein. This is what I had pictured in my mind, right? So I think this is going to work. This is going to be good. I think it's going to be quality. Right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4 again. We're keeping it the magic number 4, that's all we're doing. We're keeping a close eye on what's going on. Okay. It's like the moment you stop keeping an eye on these babies, and don't forget they're different layers each, aren't they? So they're different types of meats, they're all going to cook slightly differently. I'm calling that as well. That's being called. But I reckon these are the top layers. These have got more fat in. So, right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And that's it done. And that's all the pork belly roe. You know, it's gone home. It's fucking shook its mum's hand. It said, "You're great." Sadly, the packed lunch that you made for me today was fucking cucumber sandwiches. You know I fucking hate that. Why'd you keep doing it? I want a fucking money for a Big Mac. We've just created some awesome fucking pork crispy shit. And I'm off to school. My name's Timothy. And yeah, and that's all she wrote. And the mum was left there utterly distressed, thinking, why have I just upset my son by making him just shitty cucumber sandwiches when he could have had this? Yeah, could have done this in the morning, like myself. Why? Can't do it. Why? Not a genius. Just not a genius. Oh, just the way it is sometimes, you know, in life. You can either cross that field and come to a situation. Yeah, we're going to just return everything off now. So those are the pork ribs done. They're nicely wobbly. They've got a nice distinct flavour to them. They're going to be amazing. They're going to be mixing with the chow mein. We've still got to put the rest of the fried off garlic and chilies on them as well and all that business. They're very wobbly. So they've got, we're going to leave them to cool down. We've got a nice aspect of what's going on. All right. Right, okay, people. So I'm going to call that a. I'm going to call it a part two. Now, in part three, can everyone see that? Everyone can see the business properly, or. Right, okay. In part three, we'll be starting to get the noodles boiled, start to do the veg, and basically making the chow mein. And these will be enveloped into it. So basically, it should be part three done. Okay, right. I'm going to call that a winner-winner pork strip crispy dinner. That's part two. I'll see all these lovely people in part three. Yeah, I suppose.
Cheers.